It's almost time for word time! Woo! Starting soon, guys! It's almost time for
word time! Allie, are you ready for word time?
I'm ready for word time! Are you ready for word time? You ready to learn about how Jesus is your
solid ground?
Who's excited for word time?
I am!
Two minutes till word time starts. Find a spot to sit and join us soon.
One minute to word time! One minute!
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, word time!
Welcome everyone to word time!
WordTime. Welcome back, everyone. It's so good to see you. If you're looking for any of the words of the songs we're singing today, you can find them on trinitysanpedro.org/WordTime. Right, awesome. All right, so today, do you guys remember our theme that we've been talking about? We've been talking about solid ground. Yes, and we're talking about how when everything else in life feels really shaky or maybe scary or we're worried about things and we don't understand them or things feel really different, we can always remember that Jesus is like a solid ground that never, ever, ever changes. That's our theme. And we have a theme verse that goes with that theme that's in the book of Psalms, chapter 40, verse 2, and it says, "He lifted me out of despair, and he set my feet on solid ground. My steps are secure." That means wherever we're walking, whatever path we're on, our steps are secure and safe with Jesus. And we have a pretty cool theme song that goes with that verse. Get out your electric guitars, everybody.
I gotta tune mine.
All right, we're ready. Psalm chapter 40, verse 2. Ready? Stand up and sing with us. Stand up. Okay. He lifted me out of despair, down, down, and set my feet on solid ground. My steps are secure. My steps are secure. Psalm chapter 40, verse 2. Let's do it one more time, Ellie.
Yes.
Okay, louder this time, everybody. He lifted me out of despair, bow, bow, and set my feet on solid ground, bow, bow, bow. My steps are secure, my steps are secure. Psalm chapter 40, verse 2. Good job, everybody. Jesus is your solid ground. Let's sing one more song now about how we are more than conquerors in him who loves us. Jesus is our solid ground, and with him, we're more than conquerors over anything we're worried about or anything we're scared of. This song asks, what can separate us from the love of God? And the answer to that is nothing.
Conquerors through him who loves us,
through him who loves us. What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? What can separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus? Nothing, 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 nothing. Yeah! Awesome job, everybody. You remember that this week, that nothing can separate you from the love of God.
Hey everyone! This next part of Word Time is going to be a review of all of our stepping stones that we learn each year at Trinity. So today's is the books of the Old Testament, and that's especially for you third graders. Third graders, this is your year to learn about the Old Testament books, and we were thinking that maybe some of you have older brothers and sisters in the house that might be bored and could help you study right now. So this would be a good time to pause it and get those big brothers and sisters that already know the Old Testament books. Maybe grab a couple musical instruments from your house and check out the website. Kira will tell you the website.
Yeah, you can find all the words for the stepping stones at trinitysanpedro.org/wordtime if you need the words. Sing along with us.
Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, Kings and Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
Great job practicing your books of the Old Testament. Now we have a Bible story.
Okay, now it's time to hear about our Bible story today. Today we're talking about another story that reminds us that Jesus is our solid ground. God's mighty and is always with us, and that never changes. Today's Bible story is another example of God's might and power being with us. We're going to talk about the story of David and Goliath. Let's meet David.
That's me. I'm the youngest little brother of my family. But God has big plans for me.
That's right. David's dad, Jesse, had 7 sons, and David was the littlest one. But he knew God really well. God said that David had a heart like his, and David would play a really important part in God's story. But today, David was still really young, and everyone thought he was just the weakling of the family.
Yeah, no one takes me seriously. They think I'm a wimp. Even right now, my brothers are out fighting the Philistine army, and I'm just here at home.
That's right. God's people had some really scary enemies, and the Philistines were the scariest of all. And now, the Philistines were here to fight God's people, and God's people were terrified.
I'm so scared. What are we gonna do?
And the Philistines had a secret weapon. A giant named Goliath.
Roar! I'm Goliath! Fear me!
Goliath was a huge man, so strong, so tall, and so scary that no one had ever been able to fight him and live to tell the tale.
Send your best soldier out to me. If he wins, we Philistines will be your slaves. But if I win, you will be our slaves. Come fight me.
No one spoke. No one moved. God's people were terrified.
You chickens. Your God can't save you. I'll rip you apart and eat you on toast. Ha 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 ha.
God's people stayed frozen with fear. They didn't know what to do. They needed someone to save them. But God would send someone to save them. Remember little David from the beginning of our story?
That's me!
One day, little David was bringing some lunch to his brothers out in the army.
Hello, brother. I have some food for you. Here's some pizza. Wait, what's everyone so scared of?
We're scared of him. Oh.
Whoa.
Scared of Goliath, the Philistine giant. We need someone to save us.
Don't be afraid. I'll fight him for you.
You're only a little boy. What are you gonna do?
God will help me.
So, little David got ready to fight Goliath. The king gave David some huge, heavy armor to wear.
Oh. I can't even move or see with this armor on. I won't need this.
And instead of armor, David grabbed 5 smooth stones and a slingshot. Then he approached Goliath.
You, God's people sent me a little boy?
I'm little, but God's big.
You could never defeat me.
It isn't swords and muscles that save you. It's God who saves you. This is God's battle, and God always wins his battles.
And with that, little David slung his sling and threw a rock at Goliath. It hit Goliath right in the head. Goliath stumbled.
Whoa.
And staggered.
Whoa.
And crash! Goliath fell down dead.
Yay! You did it! You did it, David! You're a hero!
God saved us. It was his battle all along.
God had saved his people.
Hooray! Praise the Lord!
Hooray! Let's clap for our skit characters more time. That was a great story, wasn't it? Even when God's people were terrified of a scary, scary giant, God was with them and had a plan to take care of them. God was like solid ground for little David and the rest of the Israelites. He protected them. God is with us in all of our battles. Just like David, we can say, I'm little, but God is big. Can you say that with me? I'm little, but God is big. When we feel small or weak, we can remember that God is big and bigger than anything we're worried about or anything we're scared of. And that's our big idea today. Our big idea is, I'm little, but God is big. And you remember that with this week and always, that you're even when you feel little, God is big. Let's sing our solid ground theme verse again. Stand up, wherever you are, stand up and sing with us. Stand up. Ready? Get your guitars out. Here we go. He lifted me out of despair, brown, brown, and set my feet on solid ground, brown, brown. My steps are secure, my steps are secure. Psalm chapter 40, verse 2.
Can we do that one more time?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Here we go.
He lifted me out of despair, brown, brown, and set my feet on solid ground, brown, brown, brown. My steps are secure, my steps are secure. Chapter 40, verse 2.
Great job, everybody. Remember that Jesus is your solid ground, no matter what.
Hey, guys. Thanks for joining us for Word Time today. Tune in next time on Thursday for our next Word Time at 4 p.m.
It was so fun to see you today. The next step for Word Time is to go to trinitysanpedro.org/wordtime to find your family devotion and your family activity today. Click on today's date, March 31st, and you'll find a list of questions to talk about with your family about the story of David and Goliath and a family activity about recreating the story of David and Goliath. So have so much fun with that.
And we can't wait to see you at our next Word Time and have an awesome day. Remember that Jesus is your solid ground.